Welcome to our 2015 Monsoon Outlook, produced in conjunction with Monsoon Awareness Week. The week of June 14th through the 19th has been designated as Monsoon Awareness Week in Arizona. This outlook is produced in cooperation with the National Weather Services in Tucson, Flagstaff, and Las Vegas, as well as information from the Climate Prediction Center. The North American monsoon is defined as a shift in the atmospheric wind pattern from the typical dry westerly flow during the spring to a southerly or southeasterly flow in the summer. This pattern wind shift is due to the development and positioning of a subtropical high pressure system. Once this high pressure system becomes established over and north of the local region, moisture is capable of being pulled into northern Arizona from both the Pacific and Gulf of Mexico, eventually becoming manifested into thunderstorms. The position of this high will dictate whether the monsoon is active with frequent thunderstorms or inactive with little or no thunderstorm activities. There are some features favoring early establishment of the high pressure over the Four Corners, including lack of snow cover. This allows the ground to dry and warm quicker than usual in the spring and provides a positive feedback mechanism for the high pressure development. Also, drought has been a reoccurring theme over the western United States and plains, which also favors a preferred location for high pressure development over the central Rockies. However, recent heavy rainfall in the plains may disrupt this pattern, which has been prevalent over the past 2 years. As mentioned previously, some of the influences on the position of this high may be antecedent snow cover, where lack of snow favors quicker development of a stronger high pressure system further to the north, and vice versa for excess snow cover, and drought conditions over the Rockies and plains, which can yield favorable summer season high pressure development. But a mature El Nino can be a negative influence towards the northward progression of the subtropical high, favoring prolonged westerly flow and subtropical jet activity. On the other hand, El Nino can also favor enhanced East Pacific tropical activity, which could potentially aid in moisture transport into Arizona. Lastly, the positive phase of the Pacific decadal oscillation can sometimes be detrimental towards persistent high pressure over the Four Corners, but this correlation is somewhat weak. Weak El Nino conditions have been prevalent in the tropical Pacific since the winter. However, recently, much stronger sea surface temperature warming has occurred, and the El Nino measure has strengthened through the late spring and has been approaching the moderate category. While the atmosphere was slow to respond during the winter, a more robust change in circulation patterns had been noted within the past month. The Pacific decadal oscillation has shifted into positive phase last year, with some measures this past winter and spring peaking at their highest positive readings in many years. While these Pacific Ocean temperatures and associated changes in atmospheric circulation patterns could conceivably lead to a delayed onset and drier conditions during the monsoon season, the linkage and correlation is still somewhat weak at this time of the year. Looking historically at combined July, August, and September precipitation totals across the state, there is a weak correlation between El Nino and reduced rainfall across the central and southern parts of the state. Little correlation exists over the northern part of the state. It must be reiterated that this connection is only weak, and there are several competing influences on summer monsoon weather this year. Also, just by the nature of monsoon thunderstorms, rainfall amounts during any thunderstorm or event, or even the seasonal rainfall anomalies, can be very localized even within the larger climate division. Concentrating down to a couple of the larger cities around the state, this figure shows monsoon season rainfall for Tucson, Phoenix, and Flagstaff during the past six established or rapidly developing summertime El Nino events. As can be seen, while at least half of the years had below average rainfall during the monsoon, there were several years with above or near average rainfall. Therefore, while there may be a tendency for below average rainfall during the monsoon season during El Nino events, this trend certainly does not hold true every year and is not necessarily statistically significant. In forecasting the potential for weather during the monsoon season, not only do we look at the underlying El Nino, drought, etc., other information, but we also utilize dynamic climate models that attempt to bring all this information into one defining forecast. In order to best represent the probabilities of above, below, or near normal precipitation or end temperature, we use several different climate models and combine them using historical skill measures. This model ensemble approach, along with human intervention and past experience, leads to larger scale climate seasonal outlooks for the United States. These seasonal outlooks are based on the combination of El Niño phase, ocean temperatures, climate ensemble output, and trends over the past 10 to 15 years versus the longer term average. Now, these are probability forecasts, not deterministic forecasts. That is, a 35 to 40% chance of above normal temperatures or above normal precipitation over parts of the state still equate to a 27 to 32% chance that the outcomes will be below normal. The main drivers for summer warmth in the West are trends over the past 10 years, plus the unusually warm waters hugging the West Coast. Precipitation forecasts are based primarily on multi-model ensemble data, with greater weight given to areas where the models have displayed historical skill. So, in summary, there are several conflicting and not really strongly reliable climate signals that would indicate either a wetter or drier monsoon season this year. Drought and a lack of snowfall could tend to favor an active monsoon season, while maturing El Nino and positive Pacific decadal oscillation would hint at a delayed onset and lower seasonal totals. Even in the best years where there may be a signal, we still only have limited predictive skill given the aerial and temporal nature of thunderstorm activity. Regardless of the strength of amount or of activity this season, there still is going to be periods of thunderstorms with lightning, strong winds, blowing dust, and heavy rain. So be prepared for these thunderstorms ahead of time, and know what to do to keep yourself and your family safe by reviewing the information presented in this monsoon awareness week. Thank you for viewing this monsoon outlook. For more information, please visit our webpage at www.weather.gov/phoenix for up-to-date information and the latest forecast products. The Phoenix National Weather Service is also on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.